Learn about the future of policy compliance. Azure Arc for Servers helps you go beyond existing group policy capabilities. Now you can use Azure Arc to extend governance and control to any virtual machine, whether it's running on-premises, in Azure, or even multi-cloud environments, literally running anywhere. Hi, I'm Jeff Woolsey, and this is one in a series of videos that shows you what's new in Windows Admin Center. Windows Admin Center allows you to streamline everyday tasks and connect to Azure for hybrid scenarios. In this video, I will show you how to enable Azure Arc from within Windows Admin Center and get started with Azure Policy. You'll see how, with broader visibility and control, you can identify and address expiring certificates, security baselines, and much more. Let's get started. Azure Arc really comprises three technologies we're talking about right today, which is running data services anywhere, at-scale Kubernetes management, but also the ability to organize and govern across environments. So quick question for people in the room. How many of you use group policy? Anybody? Yeah, and all the hands go up, of course. Everybody uses group policy. Now, GP is great if you're in a domain and you're using Windows, but what happens if you're in the cloud, or you're in multi-cloud, or you're using Linux, or you're not domain joined? Then what do you do? Then it gets really difficult, Jeff. Yeah. And Azure Arc is all about that. Azure Arc is about extending governance and control to any infrastructure. Essentially what you do is you need to enable Azure Arc. And you can do it from the Azure portal. That's one way to do it. But of course, because we're here talking about hybrid capabilities in Admin Center, you better believe we can do this in Admin Center as well. So here, I've got a server. This is a Silvernode 1. And in fact, you can see right over here, I'm going to select the settings. And I'm going to enable, click on Azure Arc for Servers. It's just a new option here in Admin Center, brand new this week. So I can choose the subscription. Give me 1 minute. And I can create an existing resource group or create a new one or use an existing one. If I want to use a proxy server, I can configure that. But I'm just going to click on Create. That's all I had to do. And what's happening right now is we're deploying the agent. The agent does not require a reboot, and it's registering this resource with Azure. So now I have set up this Azure. It's installed the agent. It's registered with Azure. And now it says set up Azure Arc for Servers, all taken care of. And of course, now if I want to head on over here and actually see what this looks like in Azure, I can click on it, which of course takes me to the exact right location in Azure, where I can see a whole bunch of Azure resources all readily available right here. And again, they all appear in the single, even though I'm running in Azure, this resource that's on premises currently running on Azure Stack HCI appears right here. And so now that it's doing this, I can do things like apply policy. So for example, I can head on over and configure guest configuration policy. And in fact, I'm switching on over to Admin Center doing that. And here you can see I'm at Azure Policy, and here I am for this node, Silvernode 1. You can see how I am doing from a compliance standpoint. If I actually want to drill into a specific policy, I can do that and see what those look like. And again, I'm applying these policies to physical servers, virtual machines, running anywhere. This is actually running on-premises on Azure Stack HCI. It's not running in Azure, but it's now a manageable resource. So think about things you could apply policy for. Certificates that are expiring, security baselines, making sure that Defender ATP is enabled on every one of your resources, and so many more. We've actually included a whole bunch of these already built right into Azure Policy, and if you want to create those, you can actually create your own as well. So for all those folks that raised their hand that talked about GP, a little bit of career advice. I know you've probably spent the last 10, 20 years working on GP, and it's an awesome thing because it's a critical tool in your arsenal. This is going to be the next one. You need to make sure you're adding this to your tool belt. This is going to be critical to your resume, it's going to be critical to your business card, and it's going to make you highly marketable because you are that person that can apply policy and governance to any VM running anywhere. Windows, Linux, AWS, Google, Azure, on-prem, all done here through Azure Policy.